Welcome to Canvas New Quizzes. In this portion, we will be discussing how to create and manage item banks. To begin using item banks, or if you've chosen to use them, you may want to add the item banks index page to your course navigation. Please note that while this is available for you to view, it is not available to students, even if it's visible in the course navigation menu. From within our item banks screen, we have the ability to create a new bank using the plus bank button. From here, we can name a bank. It's very important to name your banks very clearly, as you will potentially have access to a number of banks across courses, and it will make identifying those pieces necessary much easier. Note that once I add a bank, I'm automatically changed over and shown all of the banks that I have access to. The reason we encourage you to make clearly labeled banks is so that you don't have to wonder later what bank number one, Canvas quiz test are. Sample bank, share, things like that are very vague. If you're looking for ones that are just available within this course, you do have the option to choose that from the bank. And we'll talk about sharing banks in just a moment. For now, let's look at that bank we just made. From here, I have the option to rename the bank if I needed to share it with somebody, or to delete it entirely. To begin adding questions to the bank, I click on the title of the bank. Using the plus new button at the top corner of my screen, I can add any type of question to my item bank. From here, I can add any number of answer choices. If I want to only have three, I can delete that option. Again, I have the ability to shuffle those choices to lock a specific answer choice. For example, if I wanted to add a none of the above, I may want to lock that choice in place. All of my traditional options are still available to me. I still have the ability to leave specific feedback based on a correct, incorrect, or general answer. Once I'm done and I've chosen all of my options, I select Done, and the item is part of the bank. I have the ability to duplicate questions within the bank. If I do, I am prompted as to whether I want to keep a copy in the bank that I'm in or move the item to the other bank that I choose. If I'm duplicating to create multiple of the same question type, I would want to make sure to keep a copy in this bank. If I'm just copying here, I find my bank and I add. And now I have two of the same question. This helps if you're using multiple questions that have the same base. If I wanted to move that question, a duplicate, to the other bank, I can select the duplicate icon and choose a different bank from my list. And then I could decide if I wanted to keep a copy within this bank or to just move the question entirely. Note that now the question is not in the Math 110 Systems Bank any longer. The original is. One thing many folks like to do is pull a certain number of questions out of a large bank, much like we used pools in Blackboard. That ability is still available using Canvas New Quizzes. To do so, let's go to our quiz. Within that assessment, and using the build menu, I have the ability to mix and match questions that are within this particular assessment, as well as pulling questions from the bank. To add questions from a bank, I still use the plus icon at the bottom or between questions, but note the piggy bank icon at the top of the insert content menu. When I choose it, I can access any bank that I have access to. I can search for the title of the bank and click on the bank that I wish to use. From here, I can add individual questions by using the plus sign on the specific question, or to pull at random from this bank, I can use the plus all slash random button at the top. This bank, for example, has 5 questions. If I use the plus all random, I can see that it's going to pull those questions into my assessment. If I don't want all 5, or I want to change the value, I can use the pencil icon on the question and decide how many questions I want to pull and the value of each question. When I've made my decisions, I can choose done, and I can see that it's updated the point value of my assessment and tells me that it will pull 3 questions randomly from that bank at a value of 10 points per question. I can repeat this for any number of banks. Very handy for building our final exams, pulling from previous assessment banks. Another feature folks like to use is the ability to share banks. From the item banks menu, access all the banks you have, and find the one you wish to share. Using the share icon to the right, you can choose to share it with another person here, or to a specific course. For example, if you've built something and you want to use it in another course, this is great for building in your sandbox and using it later, you can share it to another course. You want to share it with another person, it's important to decide whether you want to give that user view or edit access. View access means that they can use the questions within their own assessments the same way you can, while edit access means that they can make changes to the shared bank. Once you've made that decision, choose done. The other person will get a notification letting them know that an item bank has been shared with them. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit clt.odu.edu.